Today we will discuss about the plantar arterial arch. Before we start the plantar arterial arch, I will show you this is a posterior tibial artery and this one is the lateral plantar artery and we have got the medial plantar artery. Here you can see this is a lateral plantar artery and this one is a medial plantar artery. So today we will discuss basically the plantar arterial arch, which is formed by the lateral plantar artery and on the plantar surface and the dorsum side it is completed by the dorsalis pedis artery. This lateral plantar artery, which is goes along with the first of all, it is we have got the all the muscles between the flexor digitorum brevis and the laterally flexor digiti minimi and abductor digiti minimi. In this between these muscles, the lateral plantar artery, which is goes laterally at the base of the fifth metatarsal bone. Here it gives the superficial branch. This is the superficial branch of the lateral plantar artery. Here you can see these are the again the metatarsal branches, two metatarsal branches of the lateral plantar artery. These are the plantar metatarsal artery. Plantar metatarsal artery of the lateral plantar artery. This plantar metatarsal artery before it gives the here you can see this is a perforating branches. These are the proximal perforating branches. Here I will also show you another perforating branches. Here you can see this is a perforating branches which is goes deeply. So these are the proximal perforating branches and this proximal perforating branches which is goes deep and it makes the plantar metatarsal dorsal metatarsal artery which also gives the proximal and distal perforating branch into the second. It gives the into the second, third and fourth metatarsal space. So these are the plantar metatarsal arteries. This is the fourth, third and second plantar metatarsal artery, which again divide into the proper plantar digital artery. It divide into the proper plantar digital branches. So here the this lateral plantar artery, which initially into the between the first and second layer at the fifth metatarsals base of the fifth metatarsal bone, it is goes into the deep along with the lateral plantar nerve. But we have also cut the for the better visualization, we have cut the lateral plantar nerve, and this lateral plantar artery, which is goes anteriorly, here you can see this is the deep to the this is the anterior artery and the continuation it become between the two malleoli, it become continuous as a dorsalis pedis artery. This dorsalis pedis artery, which is continuous at the first metatarso phalangeal joint first intertarsal joint, it becomes continuous inner side. Here you can see this is the it goes deep and it is completed the united with the lateral plantar artery and it completes the plantar arterial arch. And here the this dorsalis pedis artery, which also gives the one branch into the first plantar first dorsal metatarsal artery and the arcuate artery. Here the arcuate artery, which is normally it is coming from here, but here you can see these are the plantar dorsal metatarsal artery. These are the dorsal metatarsal artery, which is goes run into the dorsal metatarsal space, and this dorsal metatarsal space, which is perforating branches, proximal perforating branches into the second, third and fourth metatarsal space, and in this way In this diagram you can see here, this is the into the second, third and fourth metatarsal space. This is the arcuate artery on the dorsum of the side, and on the plantar surface this is the plantar metatarsal artery. It is a branch of the later plantar artery. This into the second, third and fourth metatarsal space. So the proximally it gives the proximal perforating, and distally it gives the distal perforating. So these are the proximal perforating and distal perforating are united through the metatarsal space. It goes into the second, third and fourth metatarsal space. Into the first metatarsal space directly dorsal spadius artery, which is continuous. Here you can see this is the dorsal spadius artery, which is continuous. And this is the first dorsal plantar metatarsal artery. These are the second, third and fourth plantar metatarsal artery, which is coming from the arcuate artery. And these are the, here it is difficult to dissect the very small branches, but it gives the perforating branches into the second, third and fourth metatarsal space, and which is anastomosis. Here this is a proximal perforating. Here you can see, I will show you, this is a proximal perforating artery. This is the proximal perforating artery. So these are the proximal perforating artery, which is goes proximally and deep, and it is these are the proximal perforator, and here there is a distally, there are distal perforator. Here you can see these are the distal perforator from the plantar metatarsal artery. So these are the plantar metatarsal artery. This one is the fourth, this one is the third, and this one is the second plantar metatarsal artery. And first one, which is the direct continuation of the lateral plantar artery, and it is anastomosis with the on the dorsum side, with the dorsum side, with the dorsal spadius artery, with the dorsal spadius artery. So this is about to the plantar arterial arch. Here the medial plantar artery we have cut, but it also gives the communicating branches to the plantar metatarsal artery, which is give the communicating branches to the first, second and third plantar metatarsal communicating branches. So this is about to the plantar arterial arches. Here you can see all the branches of the plantar metatarsal artery, and this plantar metatarsal artery gradually it becomes continuous as a digital branches, proper digital branches, proper plantar digital branches. So this is the plantar arterial arches of the, which is formed by the on the towards the sole of the foot, which is formed by the lateral plantar artery, and which is completed on the dorsum of the foot, which is completed by the continuations by the dorsal spadius artery on the dorsum of the foot. Here you can see it is the completed by the dorsal spadius artery. So this is the dorsal, this is the dorsum surface. So the dorsal spadius artery gives the dorsal plantar dorsal metatarsal artery, and arcuate artery, which is also gives the second, third and fourth dorsal metatarsal artery. And this dorsal metatarsal artery, which is goes deeper into the second, third and fourth metatarsal space, and which is communicated with the by the proximal as well as distal perforating branches. So here you can see these are the proximal perforators. Here also you can see this is a proximal perforator, and distally it is gives the distal perforators. Distally it gives the distal perforator, and then it divide into the proper digital branches. So these are the plantar surface. So this is the plantar metatarsal artery. So this is the plantar arterial artery.